Hello. So let me just start the video. Ready? So today I'm talking about Plato. Plato was an ancient philosopher. He's from Athens in Greece. He was a Greek philosopher. He was actually a student of Socrates. So even from history books, we know Socrates through Plato. So they had different ideologies, but they are not very far from each other. So I'm gonna concentrate on Plato on this video. Yeah, I hope you'll be with me till the end. So let me start with the first three most popular books from Plato. The first one is called The Republic, the second one is called The Statesman, and the third one is called Laws. So in the first book, Republic, he discusses his thoughts about considering a state as a model, like a state as a model state or an ideal state. Then the statesman, Plato discusses what he considers characters of a good leader, you know. Then we have laws. In the Book of Laws from Plato. So, from the Book of Laws, Plato discusses what he considers to be the second best state, you know. So that's just an overview of his books, most popular books. There are three. Then we move to what we call the model state of Plato. So we're going to expound what it means. So in the model state of Plato, or a utopian state, if you like, he argues that the state should have characteristics of an aristocracy. So he believed that citizens of the ideal state were to be divided into three classes. So the first class was to be the guardian class, the rulers. Let me give an example of what we have right now, like let's say our presidents, the ministers, everything. Then we had the auxiliary class, which could consist of military or soldiers, if you like. So the third one was the commoners. The commoners, as just the name suggests, is just anybody else other than the first two classes. So in the guardian class or the rulers class, the guardians were supposed to be the actual rulers, you know, and were to be a privileged elite class, you know. Then we had a system that could place these people into power, you know. He actually favored an educational system from his arguments. Then we have the second class, which is the auxiliaries. These auxiliaries were meant to be knowledgeable, but in addition, were to be trained for full-time military and defense system in the state, you know. So if you look at the first class, the rulers, you'd see they were to be chosen through an educational system, and that's what we have right now. So you can see the impact of Plato's, you see, philosophy. Then we have the auxiliaries. Of course, we've said those are soldiers or the military people. Then we have the third class, which are the commoners. The commoners were to constitute of the artisans, the farmers, just the normal, you'd say the lower caliber of people. Then they were meant to serve by providing food or other services required by the state. So according to Plato, you know, the state is divided into three classes. He also like paralleled these three classes with the human nature. The human nature, he said that it had three elements. So let me name the three elements that coincide with the three classes of society that Plato favored. So the three elements are the philosophic element, the spirited element, and the appetitive element. Let me repeat: the philosophic element, the spirited element, and the appetitive element. So, how they coincide with the three classes, the auxiliary, the guardian, and the commoners, is in this form. The philosophic element it is the is the part of the soul that has desire for knowledge. Then we have the spirited element. The spirited element is the part of the soul that is passionate towards combat and victory. So we have the philosophic element that has desire for knowledge, then the spirited element that has the affinity for combat and victory, then we have the appetitive element, which is concerned with accumulation of material things. So let me just relate them with the three classes that Plato outlined. So the guardian class, who are the rulers, who are supposed to have more of philosophic element, the capacity for knowledge, the desire for knowledge. Then we had the auxiliaries, who had to have the spirited element, passion for combat and victory. Then we had the third class, who are the commoners, the appetitive element, who are the desire for accumulation of material things. So according to Plato, now these three classes coincide with the three elements of the human soul, and that's where he came up with this famous saying that the state is the individual writ large. The state is the individual writ large. So let me expound what that quote means. Whatever you have in the state comes from the people, the individual people. Are you seeing now the relationship? Anyway, moving on to the next part of Plato's philosophy is the types of governments that he outlined. He favored an aristocracy. See, even from the beginning I said Plato was for aristocracy. He wanted an ideal state to have characteristics of an aristocracy. So according to the book called The Republic from Plato, he identified imperfect societies and also the kind of individuals that admired such imperfect societies. One of the societies is timocracy. Timocracy is a form of government that is ruled by men of honor. You see? So this is what it means, timocracy. Let's say an example of which country is ruled by the military. Let's say maybe recently, I think it was last year but one, we had an event in Zimbabwe where Robert Mugabe was overthrown. So the military took over. So these are men of honor. You see, they have the spirited element in them. So Plato argued that it can arise when one element takes control of society, when one element of your human soul becomes more dominant than the rest. So he argued that for a society to remain perfect, you needed to balance other things within the society, like art, everything, so that we cannot have an inclined spirited element that subjects a society to become imperfect. So the second type of society that Plato outlined that was not good for any state was oligarchy. So for most of you, you've heard this word so many times. An oligarchy is simply a society that is ruled by the wealthy. You know, which example can I give? Let's say even in Kenya, a country like Kenya, you'd see from the history, all the presidents have been the richest. I don't know about Kibaki, but that's my assumption. They've been having that the royalty above the common citizens. And this royalty comes from wealth. They are wealthier than everybody. That's how they easily get power. So an oligarchy. And an example is let's say Jimmy Wanjigi sponsors elections. So it becomes an affair of the wealth. Who takes power? Anyway, let's move on. So actually, from the oligarchy that Plato outlined is where Karl Marx got his ideas, that he invented the class struggle, you know. So you can see how the relationship between the ancient philosophers and the Renaissance philosophers came about, you see, the Enlightenment philosophers. So for Plato, he believed that an oligarchy would devolve from a democracy normally, and it makes sense because, you know, the accumulation of wealth would fall into a small group of people at the top, a clique of people at the top, and then they'll gain political power and everything. Their power will depend on the wealth, so that will become an imperfect society. And when Karl Marx looked at Plato's arguments, he concluded that the accumulated wealth would bring about strained relationships between the two classes. He called them the bourgeoisie and the proletariat. You see? Then third imperfect society from Plato was the democracy. Plato argued that the democracy, it's actually a society in which all the citizens have equal opportunities to hold a public office, regardless of their ability. You see, that's what Plato argued. He thought a democracy was a society where all citizens have equal opportunities to hold public offices. Now, in such a situation, rulers are likely to have freedom to do as they wish due to lack of understanding of the responsibility given to them. And in such a state, there is lack of respect for authority and rule of law. So, Plato went ahead and argued that since there will be lack of respect for authority and the rule of law in a democracy, then an anarchy will be created. That's why he thought a democracy is imperfect, is not a good structure of government. Let's go on. Another imperfect society was a dictatorship. That's obvious. Plato thought that a dictatorship or a tyranny would arise from an oligarchy, you know. Then from an oligarchy we'd have a democracy. Then from a democracy, when we have conflict between the rich and the poor, when we'll have conflict between the rich and the poor, the result will be that a leader is likely to emerge from that anarchy and establish a democracy. Are you seeing now the argument? Anyway, so for Plato, he believed that an ideal state would only be an aristocracy. Okay, ruled by the best born, okay, the best characters in society would take different positions. So a summary of what I've done is that, you know, I've explained the origins of Plato. I've even outlined how we know Socrates through Plato. And Plato was for the utopian system of government. And then he had three classes in a state, which were the auxiliaries, the rulers, or the guardian class, and the third class was the commoners. Then between the three classes, they would directly coincide with the human nature, the elements of the human nature. The human nature has three elements, which are the spirited, the philosophic, and the third one is the appetitive. So these three would coincide with the three classes in society. So the first class, let's say the rulers, would coincide with the philosophic element, because he favored an education system to put rulers in place in a society or a state. Then, that's we've talked about the philosophic element. Now, the second element, the spirited element. This was a part of the soul that was was concerned with combat and victory. This would be a part of your soul that would go into the directly, like would push you into the auxiliaries, because the auxiliaries contained military or soldiers. Then we had the third element of your human nature. The third one was the appetitive element. The appetitive element coincided with the commoners. The appetitive element was concerned with accumulation of material things. So the commoners were to work for the state, you see, to help the state acquire resources. So when you have more of this appetitive element, you'd fit into the commoners. Okay, so I've also gone ahead and outlined the imperfect societies. I've explained why Plato thought that they were imperfect. I've talked about democracy, a timocracy, a tyranny or dictatorship. So that's pretty much what I wanted to talk about today. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and don't forget to like and subscribe, and even share with your friends if you like. Bye, next time. Cool.